Welcome to WB Mason Postgame Extra, exclusively on SNY.TV. Tuesday night, the Mets began their final road series of the year against Washington. And as usual, the Nats beat the Mets 4-2. 14 of 17, Washington has beaten New York this year. This time, it was just one little mistake by Bartolo Colon that opened the door for the Nats to have their big inning.
You know, when you're playing against a team that seems to, well, not seems, is dominating you, you can't make those little mistakes. And in the fifth inning, Franzen led off with a ground ball that Duda just made a fantastic play on. It would have been a uplifting to the ball club, but instead it was just the opposite. Colon didn't get over there in time, and by the end of that inning, LaRoche came to bat, and LaRoche has been the, what is it in French, the rock, right? He's been the rock for them all season long. Three-run home run, really. Didn't put the game out of reach, but put the Mets behind the eight ball.
He was late getting off the mound. You know, when he saw Lucas dive for the, you know, when he saw Lucas dive for the ball and catch it, he got just a late break and, you know, didn't get over there. These guys really beat him up the last time they faced him, and I said he's going to pitch good tonight. And, you know, he certainly did until that point.
Mets had chances later on. They left the bases loaded in the seventh inning. They got a one-out triple from Travis d'Arnaud in the eighth inning and didn't score. They got a man aboard in the ninth inning and didn't score. And Tanner Roark, who has beaten the Mets four times this year, becomes the first National or Expo to do that since Dennis Martinez some 27 years ago.
Imagine now he's 5-0 in his career against the Mets, 4-0, like you said, this year. And how does he do it? He doesn't strike anybody out. Well, one today. But he doesn't walk anybody, throws strikes, changes speeds, and he's had a great year. Both pitchers, Colon and Roark, were going for their 15th win today. Roark came out on top. He's had a fantastic year, ERA under 3.
They beat you in so many ways. I mean, you've got, they got three or four guys, they got 80 RBIs, so they spread out the, you know, you're not, they don't depend on one guy. And Rendon's not even in the lineup tonight, but you can put him in that mix. You know, they beat you with power, they can beat you with speed, they can beat you with pitching, they beat you with defense. And, you know, that's why they're good, and that's why they sit where they are.
So the Mets can no longer dream of a winning season. They could still get to 500 if they can win out. That starts on Wednesday night when Dylan G pitches against Gio Gonzalez. Our coverage begins at 6 o'clock with Cadillac First Pitch on SNY. That'll do it for WB Mason Postgame Extra. Be sure to join us after every game for exclusive coverage on SNY.TV.